Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2101, Stratifications with a Pivot Table. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is one of the things I talk about all the time in my live Power Excel seminars, and I'm surprised I don't have a video out on YouTube once. And this goes back to when I was working in accounting 20, 25 years ago, and we had this great VP of sales who moved from California to our home office. And John, they had to find a corner office for him, so he ended up on my floor, and he was surrounded by cubes and cubes and cubes of people doing order entry. And so every day, John will walk past all these order entry people, and he would look at all the payroll that was involved in order entry. And to John, our business was simple. Every month, he would have $1 million sale, right? And those were the things that made him all the money. The reason we had 18 or 20 order entry people was because we were then selling spare parts, batteries, and you know, things that broke. And he was looking at all of these small orders and how many people we had to employ for the small orders. And he's like, I want to give all those small orders away. Just find a value-added reseller. Let them deal with the small things. I just want to deal with $1 million orders. You could get rid of all these order entry people. Just have one person to enter my big order each month. And so I wanted to demonstrate to John those small orders were higher profit, right? And I did that using a pivot table. So choose one cell. This is our invoice register, 2 years worth of data. Let it go to a new worksheet, click OK. And now this pivot table is going to be unlike any other pivot table you've ever built, because we're going to take the revenue field, which normally goes to the values area, and we're going to move it to rows like that, right? And these are dollar amounts, right? So here's an order for $1,735. Here's an order for $1,741. And all the way down at the bottom, those are the big orders, right? The $1 million orders, all right? So first thing, very unusual, taking a numeric field and moving it to rows. Second thing that's very unusual is we're going to take a text field, such as customer, and move it to values. Right, that just is, this is completely backwards. Usually customers would be here, some of revenue there. And this says count of customer, but this is really number of orders. Right, so we're seeing that there was one order for $1,699, one order for $1,736. And again, not interesting in this current format, but this is where pivot tables are really good. They can help us create stratifications. Take this data and show it in layers or in buckets. So we choose our first revenue field and then say group field. And they choose some crazy things here. And I always override this. So I'm going to go from zero to $1.6 million in, let's just say, $10,000 buckets like that. And you might have to experiment with this. You can always come back to this grouping field and change it. But I want to really kind of focus on those small orders and click OK. All right. And now here we are. We can see for each of these items, there were, sure enough, 458 small orders under $10,000, 530 orders under $20,000, between $10,000 and $20,000, and then it kind of falls off, not too many orders up there in the $20,000 to $29,000. Now, what would be really nice here is if in the grouping we could have different size buckets, right? That would be good, because these items up here, I really want that just to be one big bucket. Ah, yeah, can't do that. All right, but now that I have this simple, I mean, it's a one-page report, right? It'll get my point across. I'm going to take profit and move that to the values area. I'm going to take profit and move it to the values area again. And I'm going to take profit a third time and move it to the values area. And for each of these, we're going to change the calculation. All right. So the first one, I just want to see how many dollars are in each bucket. But then the second one, I'm going to double click. I'm going to say show the values as a percentage of the column. So percentage of profit. And then here I'm going to say a running percentage, so show values as, and this is brand new in Excel 2010, so if you're for some reason back in Excel 2007, you're not going to have this one, the percentage running total in. You'd have to build the calculation outside the pivot table. So accumulated percentage of profit, click OK. All right, so I can say, hey, look, John, you know, if you're going to get rid of all these small orders, yeah, it's a lot of orders, but it's over a third of your profit. All right, and if you're going to be losing 20 points in all of these, you know, that is a huge chunk of money that you're going to give away. Now, hey, one thing to watch out for here with the stratifications is that field revenue that I put in the rows area, that field's not going to work in this pivot table by default. If I take the revenue field and drag it down here to the bottom, it will always default to count. I don't quite understand why that happens. I know it happens, and I'm used to it. Double click and first change it to sum, and then maybe change it to whatever calculation you want to do, a percentage running total in, and we'll call this accumulated percentage of revenue, like that. Click OK. And sure enough, you'll be able to see that, you know, yeah, it's 22% of the total revenue, but higher profit margin on those small items, almost 30% of your profit. And you can at least try and make the argument that there's value to all of those folks over an order entry because they're entering high profit orders. All right, so creating stratifications in a pivot table. Now, all kinds of pivot table topics are in this book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel, 617 Excel Mystery Solved. Click that I in the top right hand corner to go and take a look on how to buy the book. Today's episode, creating stratifications with a pivot table. First, we build a pivot table. It's kind of backwards. Revenue in the rows area and customer in the values area. Select that first revenue cell in the pivot table. Use the group command. Choose a bucket size and a starting point. It'd be nice that the buckets could be variable, but they aren't. Add additional fields such as profit, percentage of the column, and running percentage total in. When you reuse revenue, though, be careful. Make sure to change from count to sum or your numbers will be wrong. All right, there you go. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.